myself Professor Nikhil Patel, EC department, LDRP ITR, Gandhinagar. Today I perform one practical of a subject, electronics device and circuit, to study the VI characteristics of PN junction diode. Dear student, as we know that the PN junction diode having the so many applications in the real world. The PN junction diode is used in the rectifier circuits, it used in the clipper circuit, clamper circuit, voltage multiplier circuit and so on. So to design such kind of application of PN junction diode, we have a basic knowledge of PN junction diode. Dear student, as we know that the PN junction diode are formatted by using a combination of two semiconductor. One is a P-type semiconductor, another is a N-type semiconductor. In the P-type semiconductor, as we know that the majority is a hole and minority is a electrons. In N-type semiconductor, the majority is a electron and minority is a hole. When we apply, do not apply any supply, then one depletion region is created between the two sides of the junction that oppose the flow of current without any supply voltage. To study the VI characteristics of PN junction diode, we require the following components. First, we require a PN junction diode having the name of 1N4007. We require one resistor having the value of 1 kilo ohm, some connecting wires to connect the circuits, breadboard, and for the multimeter, we require to measure the current as well as voltage. See here the student, the circuit diagram of PN junction diode. As we know that the PN junction diode are working in the two bias condition. One is the forward bias condition and one is the reverse bias condition. When P-type of semiconductor is connected within the positive terminal of the battery and when N-type of semiconductor is connected to the negative terminal of the battery, this configuration is known as a forward bias condition. In the reverse case, when the P-type semiconductor is connected to the negative terminal of battery and N is connected to the positive terminal of battery, this configuration is known as a reverse bias condition of the PN junction diode. Now, see the circuit of forward bias condition. Here we use the 0 to 15 volt DC supply, one resistor, one diode, 1N, the number of diode is 1N4007. See here, the size of resistor is 1 kilo ohm. Here, the anode is connected between the positive terminal of battery and cathode is connected to the negative terminal of the battery. This condition is known as a forward bias condition. Same way, in the reverse bias condition, the reverse is there. The anode is connected to the negative battery and cathode is connected to the positive terminal battery. This condition known as a reverse bias of PN junction diode. Either we change the potential of this, otherwise we change the direction of diode. This either go for forward to the reverse bias of the junction. Now start with the working of the PN junction diode. When the P is connected to the positive terminal battery and N is connected to the negative terminal battery, this configuration known as a forward bias condition. So when we increase the here potential, start from the 0.1, 0.2, 0.3 and so on. What happened, dear student? The hole having the positive charge carrier and electron having the negative charge carrier. The holes in the P-type semiconductor are attracted toward the negative terminal battery and electron in the N-type semiconductor are attracted toward the positive terminal of the battery. That's why these holes are moved into the these directions and these electrons are moved into the this direction. Now, what happened here, student? This depletion region, when we increase the supply voltage, this depletion region start to decreases. And at a 0.7 voltage for silicon, it almost negligible and the current is start to increase. Same way, if we use the germanium PN junction diode, the voltage is required is 0.35 volt for the germanium.
This voltage is also known as a knee voltage or conducting voltage. The definition of knee voltage is the voltage at which current start to increases is known as a knee voltage. It is 0.7 for the silicon and 0.35 for the germanium. Now, as per this circuit diagram, we design a circuit in the breadboard. See here the students. Here, as per this circuit diagram, here we require a 0 to 15 volt DC power supply. Here we use a 0 to 15 volt DC power supply. Next, the output of the 0 to 15 plus 5 volt supply is connected to the resistor. See here the plus terminal of this supply is connected to the resistor. After the next terminal of the resistor is connected to the positive terminal of the battery and minus terminal of the multimeter, which measure the current in the circuits, and the negative terminal of the battery is connected to the anode terminal of the diode. See here, the negative of the battery is connected to the anode terminal of the diode, and the negative terminal of the battery is connected to the cathode of the diode. See here, this is the current meter and this is the voltage meter, which measure the voltage. Now we start to increasing. Now we start apply the prepare the observation table. This is the input voltage which we have to apply from DC power supply, and we measure the current in the circuit and the voltage across diode. Now we apply slowly 0.1 voltage. As we hear, when we apply 0.1 voltage, then the current across the circuit is zero, because the diode is non-conducting position. The depletion region is not zero in that condition. Then the current is zero, and the voltage across diode is almost 0.12 around it. Same way, if we increase the voltage 0.12, 0.2 volt, then same way, see here the student, the current is almost zero and the voltage across diode is 2. In this condition, the circuit is work as a open circuit. Same way, here we apply, same way, go for the 0.3 voltage, 0.3, again the current is zero and the voltage is 0.31, diode is under, again, non-conductive position. When we apply the 0.4 voltage, then the there are little amount of current is start in the circuit is almost negligible, 0.02, and the see here the voltage drop are start and the voltage is 0.38. Now our next reading is 0.5 volt. At the 0.5 volt, some little amount of current is start flow into the circuit because the depletion region is start to reducing and near to zero. When here apply the 1 volt, so on, we apply the different voltage at the 1 volt, the current is, see here, the start the, when we above go for the 0.7 volt for the silicon diode, the current is start suddenly and the current is 0.47 and the voltage across diode is 0.49. Same way for the next reading, here we apply 2 volt and the current is, see here, again start very rapidly because the diode now in the conducting position. Same way, 3 volt configuration, current is 2.42 and 0.57. Same way, here we apply 5 volt, then current is 4.24 and 0.6. Same way, for here we apply the 7 volt, the current is increased very rapidly in the circuit, and see here the voltage across diode remains constant. As per our VI CAT 6, the current is almost zero at a certain 0.0123, and after 0.4 it start to somewhat increasing, and as we increase the voltage, the current is start the into the rapidly in terms of milliampere. See here in your circuit, and the voltage across diode, this voltage is known as a knee voltage, and this is almost constant around 0.6 to 0.7 for the silicon diode. If we use the germanium diode, then it is 0.3 to 0.35 voltage. See here, now we go for the next 10 voltage. 10 volt, the current is now again rapidly start 9.16, and see here almost nominal change in the voltage across diode. And our last reading is we go the 12 volt supply. The current is 11.15 and is 0.65. See here, student, normally see here, take any one reading. See here, the 10 volt supply is there. My input voltage is 10 volt. The drop across diode is 0.65. So drop across diode is 0.65. So we have minus from our input voltage. The net voltage is around 9.35 voltage. Now see here, the resistor we use here 1 kilo ohm, simply equation I equal to what, V by R. The net voltage is 9.35 and the resistance of 1 kilo ohm having the produced current 9.35 milli ampere. See here, the digital almost is near to our theoretical value. So see here the value 11 point, and so this is known as a VI characteristics of forward bias condition of PN junction diode. Now go for the reverse bias condition. In reverse bias condition, the anode is connected to negative battery and cathode is connected to the positron battery. First we go for the zero. Now we just change the terminal of the battery, positive and negative, and this is connected to minus. Now as we see here, increase the voltage. See here, as we increase the voltage from such kind of range, the current is almost zero, and the direct the voltage are appear here, because see in the circuit the holes attract toward the negative terminal battery and electron attract toward the positive terminal battery. So this increase, the holes move into this side and electrons are moving into this side. This increase the region of depletion region, and the current across the diode almost zero, and the voltage at which the junction is breakdown is known as a breakdown voltage. So see here, as we increase the voltage, the current is almost zero and the direct voltage is across appear the circuit. There is no current flowing into the circuit in the reverse bias condition. Thank you, students.